I was living in Vienna for 2 months, and I met very often on the suburb, on the metro station, a young guy who was playing on violin. And I wondered what's going on with him. And I exchanged a few words, and then this guy suddenly disappeared. But he remembered, he remained in my mind, and I remember him, and I decided to write a book about him, about a young man who is searching for the art and himself. And so it's about a kind of a lost generation. I wanted to write about somebody who is young, I'm no more, but I remembered when I was young, how I was longing for art, for writing, for music, for painting, for everything. So I belong to the generation which was active. We were politically active, etc. Suddenly, I see the young people as the lost generation. So I decided to write a book about Mr. Nobody. And it's sometimes heavier than to write about somebody who has some clear goal in his life. So, and somebody met, also as I met this guy in the suburb, and he go with him back in his born, in the city where he studied, in Ljubljana. And then his life starts again, anew. He tried to be a businessman, to earn some money, that after he will earn that money, he will try his career as a musician. It's a kind of nostalgia for the portrait, as an artist, as a young man. We all remember our beginnings, and somebody succeeded and somebody not. Many of them. My friends who were trying to be musicians or painters or to be in the theater, famous actors or something. But mostly they went other ways. Only a few of us became something or somebody. And so I wanted to explain how things could get wrong, on wrong direction, as with my hero, my Cyril, whom I love somehow. I was in love with him, but I couldn't do the other way that I did. So it is a story about somebody who would like to find the essence and sense of his life in music. But unfortunately, he is in one moment, he realized that he needs some money. And so he is suddenly in a strange relation with a businessman who is man of power, who is who can step on every head whenever is needed. And so it was not lucky and good solution for him, for his life. So he's hesitating about his life, his longing for art, for music, and earning money like many, many young people today. And he says his talent, his longing, his life, sense of life for something what is wrong, yes. Because he just thinks that he can postpone something, he's the real thing that he is interested in, that he can postpone and he will earn some money and then some more money, but he is deeper and deeper in this kind of business, marketing business or whatever, and which is on the edge of a criminal. And we are deeper and deeper into some Eastern European stories about the smuggling some things and so on. It's a novel about nowadays, especially if we have in our mind Eastern Europe, you know, after the Berlin Wall, people were convinced that we are arriving in the paradise of Europe, of capitalism, of everything. But suddenly things changed. They realized that it is quite a cruel world, especially for young people. because I was also involved somehow in politics in the 80s in an attempt to have democracy, to turn over the old regime, totalitarian regimes. And we were dreaming about democracy, and then we woke up in capitalism, and a quite cruel way of capitalism. And for me, this was no more the problem. I had some money, I was old enough, but for the young generation, that was really a problem of existence. Where to go, how to go after my talent or to go somewhere for money. So it's a contemporary novel also about the new Europe. Part of me is in Cyril, great part, but also in Stefan. As you know, the sentence, famous French sentence, Madame Bovary, c'est moi.